With the 1906 steamship Ticonderoga and an 1870s lighthouse from Lake Champlain, Vermont's famous Shelburne Museum is a trip back in time. So what better place to find Carl Pierre Marini?
Seen as why.
The Leominster, Massachusetts public access TV manager spent 5 years in his home workshop constructing an exact replica of the device that stars
or even greater speed
in the 1960 movie The Time Machine, based on an H.G. Wells story.
People would come to my house. People cleaning the furnace would come in and see it in the basement and say, you know, what the heck is that?
He's now showing off his handiwork as part of Shelburne Museum's celebration of science fiction and fantasy on display through October.
The human imagination is boundless.
Curator Corey Rogers showcases some of the many different ways people imagine the future. A coin-operated kiddie ride from decades ago, new large robot sculptures, and small toy robots, many from the leading makers in post-war Japan.
A lot of these have the word atomic built into them. What does that say?
It's irony, actually, because what happened was is after World War II, when they were defeated by the atomic bombs, the Japanese toy industry was asked to create toys for the American market, and atomic energy was the latest thing.
A mad scientist-style lab, complete with an eyeball that appears to follow you through the gallery, is part of a section on steampunk, a design aesthetic that's part Victorian era, part high-tech. Fashionable Star Wars characters and wild gizmos and whirligigs may be the norm in a steampunk world.
Escapism from reality.
With old Flash Gordon spaceships, you start thinking, did we really expect back then to be flying on rocket ships by now? Or did we just wish it? And you wonder, what's next?
And what's great are those children who, for some weird reason, decided to preserve their toys. We're very thankful for those kids.
And the museum is grateful for grown-up children like Carl Pierre Marini, who seems to have never lost his imagination.
I think when people walk in, they're going to hopefully be wowed by the design.
In Shelburne, Jack Thurston, News Channel 5.